Today I'm going to be talking about Ubuntu Tweak. Now this is a handy little tool that can allow you to do various things within Ubuntu. For example, you can add and remove programs using tick boxes. You can disable auto start of various programs. You can show or hide desktop icons. You can also disable recent document lists and also change the default programs for opening various files. It will also allow you to change the default thumbnail size, and also it will allow you to disable hibernation. So first of all, let's go and find this program. And you can actually find it in Softpedia, and I'll put the link in the description for you. Now, when you get to this page, you need to look for Ubuntu 8.10 Deb All. Now, I'm using Jaunty Beta, and it's working on that. So I'll just zoom in for you there. Just click on that one there. You're into 8.10 Deb All. Now, once you've downloaded that, you just double click on it. That's what you'll find there. You just double click on that. You put your password in and it'll install it. It'll actually install it and applications and system tools. See? So to run the program, just click on it. Now it'll give you some basic information about your computer, but what we're looking at really to start off with is adding and removing programs using the tick box. Now, as you can see, there's a list of programs, but it's a lot easier than using the default Ubuntu add and remove programs, because this time you can just be able to tick what you want and then click apply, give your password, and it will install automatically for you rather than you type in every single program that you want. Now it hasn't got the full list of programs, but it's got the more popular ones. Now moving on, so if you want to disable or to start of various programs, it gives you options here. Now if you're uncertain with these programs, just leave them alone, otherwise you could screw up your system really. Now, the ones I definitely don't want are Bluetooth Manager, because I don't have any Bluetooth devices, Evolution Alarm Notifier, I don't even use Evolution, and Remote Desktop, don't use that function, and Visual Assistance, don't need that function either, so I've just unticked those four. I've left the others alone because, to be honest with you, I don't really know much about them, so I'm going to leave them alone. Now, let's move on to show or hide desktop icons. Now here you can tick to show the desktop icons, and you can actually show, like in Windows, you know, home PC, you can call it My Computer, you can call it anything really, and it's the same for your home folder icon, and you can show the trash as well. You can actually see these icons on Linux Mint. They've made it sort of windowish that way, if you like, you know, but you know, you don't have to have these desktop icons, you can disable a lot really. The choice is yours. So let's move on now to disable the recent document lists. So let's have a look now, where is it? Right, there it is, it's under GNOME. You can actually lock down panels if you need to do that, but the one I'm after here is just untick enable system-wide recent documents lists. It gives you a bit of extra privacy really, if you're worried about that. Let's see now, I want to look at changing default programs for opening various files. So we need to go to system, we need to go to asset file type manager. Now basically, often it's a case where the default program for viewing video files is Totem, and to be honest with you, it's okay, don't get me wrong, but I prefer VLC. Now I would prefer VLC to be my default player for various files, so I'm going to show you how to do it. You click on video and it'll give you a list here of various videos. Now the most popular ones I use are AVIs and MPEGs, so I'm going to change all my AVIs from opening with Totem to VLC. Now to do that, you select AVI and you click edit towards the right here. Okay. Now when you click edit, you simply choose VLC media player and then you just click close and it's changed. And I want to do the same for MPEG as well. So edit, change to VLC and close. And you can do that as you wish really. And the same for images on audio, anything you want to change there, you do exactly the same way. Now just to prove the point, I've got an AVI here. I'm just going to double click on it and it should open with VLC Media Player. And it does, straight away. So that now is my default media player. Okay. Now then, moving on. So I want to now change the default thumbnail icon size because that is too small, so I'm going to try and make that bigger. Let's see, I have to go to Nautilus, and if you look here, default thumbnail icon size in pixels, it's, at the moment it's 96. I'm going to increase that to, let's make it 160. Let's minimize that, and if you notice, that's got a lot bigger. Yeah. Again, I'll just revert back to what it was. Right, and the final tip is if you want to disable hibernation, then obviously you click on power management and you untick enable hibernation. And that's basically it really. It's a very, very handy tool. It'll help you complete some tasks with ease. And thanks for watching, basically. Thank you.